belted before he could get out of the backfield. Give him a loss of 6 yards, and it brings up third down. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Now Aikman, third and long. He's going to let this go for the end zone. And oh, it'll be intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Back now in Arlington. It's the Steelers with the football, but trailing here as we get going in quarter number four. To throw again on second down. Wilson, he's going to loft one deep left side here. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Pat Tillman. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Now, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Sacked there by Bruce Smith. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
And able to find a little space, he gets this up over the 15 to the 16. They'll get four back there on the run, but now they're looking up at a third and 12 situation. On third down, this is Jackson. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. They do get 12, but they'll be marked short. And that leads to a fourth down. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches.
Hey, exit.
They'll run with Smith. Oh, and I think he went backward. He did. Jason Garrett might be wanting to reconsider the decision to go for it there. And the Steelers, they're going to take over an excellent field position. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And that gives him now three interceptions in the game.
Well, someone's locked into what they're trying to get done in the passing game. When was the last time we had someone get three in a contest?
2011, wasn't it? Kurt Coleman.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
With the Eagles.
That's right. Then against it with the Eagles, and I believe it's against Washington and Rex Grossman.
That's correct. Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter.
Rush in. Yes.
On second down, here's Aikman. He's going to air one out. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Michael Irvin, 81 yards. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Extra point by Stenerud, up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Following the touchdown, here's Stenerud to kick it away. This will be taken very short. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time.
Throwing again here on second down, this time complete. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13. Offense for them has been at a premium. You wonder where plays like that have been all game long.
They're thinking the exact same thing themselves, but they're also looking forward now, because now these plays are really for next week, trying to get some momentum going.
Now Wilson on first down. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. Looking in zone for Jones. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Julio Jones. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further.
Well, this is exactly where I expect teams to take a shot. Right after a turnover, you count on the defense being a little bit jumbled coming out on the field, maybe catch them back on their heels, and that's exactly what they did there. They threw it downfield and really created a big play.
Yeah, you said jumbled. They were the definition of jumbled defensively. One play and into the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week? Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. They'll come up after the sack on a second and 12. Play action. Now Wilson. And he's going to go down again. Sean Lee, the longtime vet, getting in and getting to the QB. Needs something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Now it's Wilson. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Holt. Give him 19 on the play, but they will still come up a bit short. And now it's fourth down. They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. Man open, it's Moss complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. The Steelers signal for the second of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in the fourth.
12, check 13.
They'll throw on first down with Wilson. That's caught by the Hall of Famer Marvin Harrison. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. It's a Pittsburgh first down, a gain of 13. Now Allen. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. Now the Steelers going to use their third and final timeout as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two.
Hey, four down.
Play action. It's Wilson. And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Jalen Ramsey. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
All smiles and high fives on that defensive sideline. That interception will cap off what was truly a tremendous performance.
Yeah, if you can hold a team to 7 points in the NFL, that's the kind of day that you feel really good about. And I do know a few guys are going to think to themselves, held them to seven. If we'd made one more play, could have had our shutout.
Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
45, 45, Mike, 45.
We ain't giving up nothing today.
45's the mic.
Man, that's trash.
That one looks like he'll throw here. And he hits Jason Witten, the tight end. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
Ready. 10 low. Recon, 132 fighter. Go. Go.
Check Mike 45. 45, 45, 45, Mike 45.
Ready.
They'll throw on first down with Aikman. Incomplete, and we're down to 8 seconds now. Oh, Patrick Peterson, the shutdown corner, was there on the coverage.
He was defended by Patrick Peterson.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Bandit.
Smoke.
45. Mike, 45.
Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up, D.
They go play action now. Aikman. And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10.
Brings up a 3rd down and 10 yards.
Hey, wahoo!
On 3rd down, Aikman. And it's incomplete. They're still throwing to the very end, but now this game is over. So this one will end in a victory for the... Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and Charles, kickoff moments away. Quickly, what are you watching in this one?
The offensive line for both teams, because both teams have a terrific pass rush. They've got to keep their passers upright. If they have a chance to do that, they can both thrive on offense and move the ball downfield.
The kicker, Dustin Hopkins, set to get this one going. And here we go. We're underway in Madden Ultimate Team. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line.
Play. Mulaney. Ankle. Go. Back.
Hey, zero.
They'll run it with the 85 MVP, Marcus Allen. The game's first play produces 6 yards. Brings up second down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Brings up second and 4 at the 26-yard line.
Play clock down to 2, and we get a signal and a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. From the 26, they'll line up on 2nd and 4. One of the true legends of pro football, it's Jim Brown. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other bats in the league.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. This will be caught by Randy Moss. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up 2nd and 6.
Hey, alert.
No.
They'll run it here with Brown. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about 6.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
Five men in the secondary now for the Falcons on 3rd down. From the shotgun, Wilson. Got a man, it's Harrison, complete. And he's got a 1st down as he's up to the 48. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
Hey, move the team.
On 1st down, Brown. And he's over midfield and into Falcon territory. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play caller to realize you want to establish a guy of his caliber with runs like this early because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
And that'll be incomplete. 6-time Pro Bowler Randy Moss, the intended receiver. And it's 3rd and short.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete.
Left pass.
Wilson now to throw on 3rd down. Got a man. It's Randy Moss, complete. And that's going to be good for another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 29-yard line.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in the paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone?
A little bit of daylight on that first down run sets him up nicely. 8 yards on the carry. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short. Eight yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Now a carry for Brown. And not much to speak of there. Maybe a yard down to the 20. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. On third and one, Wilson. And he's got a man open. That's Allen. And he'll be taken down, as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. We're scoreless after one. Us down to about the 12 for a gain of three.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them. At the 12-yard line.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven.
I can't believe they let you play.
Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. That's their second, so they'll have one remaining here in this second quarter. We'll be right back.
Let's go, D. Tighten up. Let's go.
Got to go. In and out. Let's go.
Alert three. Alert three. Alert three.
They'll run. This is Brown. And here he'll get it down to the seven. Call it a gain of five there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
And the Steelers on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. This time they face a third and two. They'll run on third down with Brown. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Steelers take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Zane Gonzalez on for the extra point. Put it through to make it 7-0 Steelers.
Yeah. Hello? Yeah. Hey, yeah, hey, I'm gonna call you back, but I'm gonna tight game, call you back, alright?
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. Now the Steelers going to use their third and final timeout. And with that, they're now out of timeouts. There's still plenty of time remaining here in this second quarter.
Strip the ball. Strip that ball.
They'll throw on first down with Griffin.
stepping up. He's going to keep it. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Second and 9 now from the 21. To throw is RG3. And this one complete to Reed. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 27 yards there, a first down. Throwing now, Griffin on first down. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete. It was the linebacker Devin White there to knock it away.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Throw left side complete. That's Peterson. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the 45. Six. 2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. It's a gain of 11, and the Falcons pick up the first.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
On first and 10, it's Griffin. Dancing to his left. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. From the 34, they'll come to the line on second and 10. To throw again. Griffin looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Holt. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. Seems as if the passing attack's starting to heat up a little bit here in the second quarter.
You can sense and you can see the momentum because now they're reading their patterns downfield. They're understanding the coverages. And they're finding the open holes in the defense.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Now it's Griffin. Flushed out right. Throw across his body, and it's intercepted. Snags it for the pick. And they get the football, but not much on the return here as he stopped at the 7-yard line.
Well, they didn't exactly show patience there, did they? Just down a score, they come out firing right away and compound things by throwing an interception. They put their defense in a really tough spot.
After the interception, here's Wilson. There's the 8-time Pro Bowler, Marvin Harrison. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Throwing again on second down, Wilson. Will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
Well, partner, they're not content to run this one out as we head towards the half, trying to hit a big chunk play right there and add to their score.
Yeah, this is a confident group. At the very least, they're thinking field goal.
Yeah, and I don't blame them one bit. I don't think you sit on the ball going into the half when you have a chance to put some more points on the board.
Now it's Wilson. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Wilson in the offense, not coming off the field. They're going for it on fourth. Here we go on fourth with Wilson. Got a man, it's Randy Moss. And they take this up near the 30 before he's taken down. 21 yards there, a big play on fourth down. Here's Wilson. He's got Harrison, left side complete. A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. And he fires one that's intercepted. picked off by an American hero, Pat Tillman. And he's given his guys a shot for late points as they will take over in range for a field goal or maybe more. After the interception, here's Griffin. And incomplete, he dropped it in the end zone. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. From the left hash, it's a 42-yard attempt. And Hopkins' kick is good. And that will do it for this first half. That's it for the first half. 2 more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told, as he's taken down back shy of the 20. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons' offense at the line. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
And they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. Now Griffin. Throw left side complete. It's Holt, and he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The Falcon passing game looking good on this drive as they get the first down. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. A big-time gain there on the keeper, using his legs to hurt him. First down.
And teams have a tough time running the ball, as this one has throughout this game. It's so easy to just say, forget it, let's throw the football. But that's exactly why you stay with the running game. Eventually, you stick with it, you make some adjustments, you often find ways to run the ball better as the game goes on.
So now, following the big play, they've got a first and goal all the way down at the 10. From the gun, it's a give to Peterson. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Back-to-back 1-yard runs here, so that leaves them with a 3rd down and 8. Third down, it's Adrian Peterson. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down. It's 4th down. So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on 4th and 8. Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. They get the completion but cannot push forward into the end zone. And this Steeler defense able to come up with a stop. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. Here's 2nd and 9, just a yard on that last run. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. That's caught by the Hall of Famer, Marvin Harrison. And out of bounds across the 15-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down. And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on 3rd.
Check, 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 check.
From the gun, it's Wilson. Man open, it's Moss complete. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. A gain of 10, good for a Steeler first down.
Got to say, I was a little surprised to see him, Charles, come out in the shotgun on third and less than a yard.
Yeah, but the way the NFL is nowadays, we hardly ever see anyone really run for it on short yardage. So they're going to throw the football more times than not. That was a nice, easy rhythm throw right there, and they pick up the first down.
Wilson, he's going to loft one deep left side here. And that's caught inside the 35. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Randy Moss, 74 yards. And the Steelers, they broaden their lead.
And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 7. Yard line.
The Falcons take over first and 10 at their own 17 yard line.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a first and 10. Now it's AP, Adrian Peterson. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and 4 and second and 8 and 9.
They'll try and run with their fullback. Trying to keep those big legs churning, but he's going to go down in the backfield. The tally there, -2 yards, brings up third down. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Griffin. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Julius Peppers, yes, he still has it. Give him the sack. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. Here we go on fourth down with Griffin. And this is incomplete. A surprising move to go.